गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद द एक्सरसाइज 11.6. अर्लियर आई टोल्ड यू दैट दिस इज नॉट इन योर सिलेबस, बट नाउ इट इज देयर इन योर सिलेबस. सो वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट एक्सरसाइज 11.6, दैट इज सिमेट्री. इट इज बेस्ड ऑन सिमेट्री. ओके, सो दिस इज द न्यू टॉपिक फॉर यू. सो वील स्टार्ट विद द डेफिनेशन ऑफ सिमेट्री. वट इज सिमेट्री? Symmetry is a regular balanced arrangement on the both side of a line or around a point. Okay, regular balanced arrangement on the both side of a line or around a point. What is the meaning of this? Okay, let me explain you. So we'll start with the figure. Okay, so let's take a triangle. So this is a triangle. This is a triangle, okay? So, just tell me, can we divide this triangle into two parts such that both the part match exactly when they are folded along the line? Means we have to draw a line in such a way that the both side of the line should be equal. Yes, we can draw. See, how can you draw? This way. So if we draw the line in the center of the triangle, now see, both the parts are equally distributed. Okay, understood? Now see, if we take the right side and we fold it in a this way, it is exactly folded. See, this part and this part. Okay, if we take this part over the left part, we see that they overlap exactly and there is no extra part remaining here. See, there is no extra part remaining, exactly folded. Clear? So means this is a from where it is like folding properly from this line. So this is a line of symmetry. So this is a vertical line. So this is called vertical line of symmetry. Clear? Now suppose we have a triangle in this way. Okay, now again we have to divide the triangle in such a way that the both the part should be equal. Okay, so now we will draw a line in this way. Now see, we are getting the same portion both the sides, and if we fold it again, it is folding exactly. So this is horizontal line. Okay, this is horizontal line. So this is a vertical line and this is a horizontal line. Clear? Now this is one line of symmetry, because here only one line is there which is dividing both dividing a figure equally. Clear? So now in some of the figures we have more than one line of symmetry, mean two line of symmetry. This is a rectangle. Okay, clear? Now again we have to do the same method. We have to divide this triangle in such a way that both the parts should be equal. Okay, when one part is flipped over the other part, it will overlap exactly with the other. So here, where the line of symmetry? So this is the line of symmetry. This is the line of symmetry we are getting. Okay, this is the vertical line. Okay, now if we fold it from this side, again it will overlap exactly with the other side. Okay, so here we are also, again we are getting one more line of symmetry this side. So here we have two line of symmetry, vertical and horizontal. If you fold from this side, again we are getting the same, both the sides same. If we are folding from this side, again both the sides are same. But suppose we are folding from diagonal side, this is the diagonal side I told you. Okay, you will see that here we have spare like portion. Okay, it is not exactly folding. It is not like we are not getting both the parts in a. Both the parts are not same. So see. So in the diagonal side, we are not getting the same portion. So here we have two line of symmetry. Okay, in a rectangle. Now, some of the figure we have more than two line of symmetry. This is a square. So if we fold from this side, we are getting line of symmetry. Okay, clear? This is the horizontal. Okay, and if we are folding in the vertical way, so we are getting the line of symmetry. So see the diagonal side. Yes, diagonal side also, when we fold it from the diagonal side, again we are getting the same portion both the sides. Okay, so here diagonal, one diagonal here, another diagonal. From the other side also we are getting the same portion. So here we have more than two line of symmetry. So one is vertical, one is horizontal, and two diagonals. I hope you have understood. Now we are going to do the exercise, that is the exercise 11.6. Exercise 11.6. So there are two kinds of symmetry. The line symmetry we have already done, and the other one is point symmetry. What is the meaning of point symmetry? Suppose we draw a circle. This is a circle, okay, and this is the center point of the circle. If we divide a circle from this center point, okay, point symmetry from this, again we are getting the same part, clear? So if we draw from this side, both the portions are same. If we draw from this side, again both the portions are same. So from the point we can draw infinite line of symmetry. Infinite means unlimited, clear? So this is a point symmetry. So now we are going to start with the exercise. The question number one, is draw the line of symmetry on these figures. Now they have given few figures, so I have drawn the figures here. So now draw the line of symmetry. So here when we draw in the center of the figure, so here, so this is, both the sides are same, and if we'll draw from here, again we are getting the same side. So here we have two line of symmetry. Come to this side, here we have one line of symmetry. See this side figure, this portion. Okay, here also we have one line of symmetry. If we divide from here in the center, we'll get the same portion both the sides. Come this side, again vertical line of symmetry. If we draw from this side, we will get the more portion here and less portion this side, clear? Now come this side, both the sides are same. This is the line of symmetry, dotted line, that is called line of symmetry. If we draw from here in the horizontal, we will get like less portion and more portion here, so it will not be equal. Okay, so here this is a square, so this is the line of symmetry here, vertical, horizontal, and two diagonals, clear? Now this is a shape. Again, if we draw a line between this shape, we will get both the sides equal. Now move to the next one, question number two. So the question number two is, no, here some more figures are there. This side, this is the next figure. Again here we have one line of symmetry and other line of symmetry, horizontal and vertical and horizontal. Clear? Come this side. Again here we have. Now, if you divide it from this side and this side are same. Both the sides are same. Now H, if we divide it from center, we have both the sides same. And if we divide from the vertical side, again upper side and lower side both are equal. Clear? Now this is question number 2. Question number 2 is, draw a possible line of symmetry for the alphabet given below. So they have given the alphabet, so we have to draw the line of symmetry. Clear? So here, first of all, alphabet C. So C, we have a line of symmetry. See the line of symmetry of C. Okay, this is the line of symmetry. E also, we have line of symmetry. I, V, M, Y from the center, and X vertical and this side. Clear? And what are the alphabets? They don't have the line of symmetry F. So if we'll draw the line from this side, it will not be, both the sides are not same. If here also vertical and like horizontal, there is no line of symmetry. Here K. Now see the alphabet K. Here, see the alphabet K. If we draw the line of symmetry from this side, again the both sides are not same. This is the smaller side and this is the bigger side. And here also we can not have any line of symmetry, vertical or horizontal. So now we have done. Now question number 3. List all the letters of English alphabet which have no line of symmetry. No line of symmetry. So these are the alphabet F, G, J, K, P, Q, R, N, S, Z. Okay. We don't have any line of symmetry in all this alphabet. See the Z. Z alphabet. If we divide alphabet Z like this. Okay. So we have a opposite side, so they are not same. Okay, in the this direction and this direction, they are not in same direction, they are in opposite direction, so we will not get both the side in same. Okay, so Z also having no line of symmetry. Clear? Similarly, S, if you draw a horizontal line here, the both sides are opposite. Clear? Now question number 4. Draw line of symmetry for the following figures. So here we have given the figures. Now here line of symmetry is there. This way. This. Here. Clear? And T. Here we don't have any line of symmetry. Just draw this figure. Okay. Just cut the shape and just try to draw the vertical line and the horizontal line. You will not get both the sides same. So we have a 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. So in this 4 figures, we have a line of symmetry. Now move to the next one. So let us revise. Let us revise. You don't have in syllabus A part, C part, D part, F part. We don't have any syllabus. Okay. Now where is radius? This is radius for number 1. This is radius. Okay. Now diameter. Come with the diameter. Where is diameter? This is diameter. Clear? Now line symmetry. Where is line symmetry? Now part 2 is a line symmetry. Okay. Now H, reflection about vertical line. Reflection mean when you stand like in front of a mirror and you get your reflection in the mirror. So that is, if you just see K in a mirror, you will see the K like this. Okay, so this is the reflection of K. Clear? So this is, let us revise. Now move to the second question of let us revise. Oh, sorry, third question. Identify the following net and tick the correct answer. When you open a figure, okay, open a figure, cuboid and the solid figure, you get a net. Okay, I have already explained you net. Now this is the open net. This is a net Now, which figure when you join this net, so which figure you will get? See, this is all the parts are square. Okay, this is a figure made up of square. So what is this? This is a cuboid. Clear? Now move to this side. What is this figure? Cube, cuboid, cone or cylinder? This circle. When you place this circle here, you will get a cone. So this is a cone. Move to the C part. Cube, cuboid, cone or cylinder. So these two circle, when you place one circle here and the other circle here, so what will you get? This is a cylinder. Clear? Now move this side. Cube, cuboid, cone or cylinder. So here, see the shape. This is made up of rectangle. So this is a cuboid. Clear? Now here, question number 8. Draw the line of symmetry of the following figure, if any. Here this is a circle, this is the circle. We have infinite line of symmetry, means unlimited. Clear? So here we will not get any line of symmetry. If we will draw here, this like portion will be more and this is less. If we will draw this side, again this will be less and this will be more. No line of symmetry. So this is line of symmetry. In a rectangle we have two line of symmetry. Okay, here we will get one line of symmetry. Here also we will get one line of symmetry. Okay, here in this. Clear? Now practice worksheet, page number 204. Practice worksheet. So in the first question they have asked, a triangle has dash vertices. A triangle has dash vertices. Now what will be the answer? Just tell me what will be the answer. The answer is, a triangle has three vertices. Okay, a triangle has three. 1, 2, 3. The question number 2 is, which of the following alphabet has only one line of symmetry? One line of symmetry. So here A is having only one line of symmetry. This one. Clear? Because S having 2, H having 2 and K is having no line of symmetry. Which of the following alphabet has no line of symmetry? That is the K. A dice has dash faces. 6. Radial of the circle are called equal. When we draw the radius, all the sides of a radius are equal. Okay. So one more question we have done here. Come this side. Question number 4. Here we have two line of symmetry. One this and the other this. Clear? So this exercise is over. Line of symmetry. Thank you very much.